things short in the color Sienna, in a size extra, extra small slash extra small. And it is just so perfect under this tight ripped dress. I never knew that I needed solution wear, but it is just makes everything so smooth under this dress, and you can't see any of the seams. It even sort of enhances my hourglass figure. It's comfortable and breathable. I love it so much, and they're restocking on Monday, so get yours.
Do you need help?
I think I need a bigger size.
Honey, you never need a bigger size. Come here. Let me show you a little trick. Brace yourself. Suck it in. Squeeze those cheeks.
All right, I got so many people wanting me to try on the Kim Kardashian Shaper line Skims. So your wish is granted. I just popped on the sculpting bra and then the sculpting short, and I'm not sure if this is the mid-thigh one or the above the knee one. But I, first impression, big fan. I think they're really comfortable. They don't appear to be like moving around at all. I love where this pair hits me. This is like the perfect length for me for shapewear. And then I wanted to show you the back. It is sheer. I wore like patterned underwear so you can see that it's sheer. But it's more opaque down here. And then this bra is also sheer. I have little padding pads in because, you know, I don't need to be exposing myself in that way on here. But first impression, really impressed, really comfortable. I don't feel like squished to death. They weren't like impossible to get on, but I still feel like smooth. I feel like my waist is drawn in, my thighs feel smooth, and yeah, I feel really beautiful actually, which is crazy because not too long ago I was very ashamed to wear shapewear, so, and embarrassed by it. But I don't know why I feel like this is kind of changing things for the shapewear world, so I'm really excited about it, and I'm gonna try on a few more pieces for you. I just popped on their sculpting brief. This one is their like shorter one, and then this one is the one that's even like longer. And I wanted to show you just like in comparison, like this is how tiny they look, and then they fit me perfectly. Like this was not hard to get on, and that's what the back looks like. And then I wanted to show you too, while this one's like folded up, it has like this like bum sculpting technology or something in it. Like it's pretty cool how they like, I don't know what they did, but it feels like it makes like my butt look extra good. I feel like out of all of the things that she sent, I'll probably wear these two pieces the most. Also, I completely forgot to show this. I don't know what happened, but either way, they have these in front of, or on all of the shorts and briefs, and the bra has it, and it really just helps it so it doesn't fall down on your waist. And doesn't move around, which I find to be really great. And it's not like sticky. I don't even realize it's there when it's on. And then it doesn't have them on this side, which I love. And these, I've been sitting in mine and they're not moving around at all on the thigh. And I can't wait to like wear them out and like test them a little bit more. So I'll keep you posted on if they stay in place.
So we made a scavenger hunt.
No, it's
don't
a book.
Say you found an old man. Stop.
It's,
so we made a scavenger
it's a
hunt
book
at and, North Main.
And
we colored things that we're going to look for on
the map.
Our walk. Like a scavenger hunt.
And it's an inside scavenger hunt too. There's another one that's inside.
That we can do inside. But this is our outside little social distancing walk with just us.
We found an old man, a white fence. A car.
We found a stop sign and an orange tree.
Yeah.
And now we're going to find a horse. Hey, there's a red car on here, and we found the red car. We did it.
No.
And the next thing on our scavenger hunt is a horse. Hi, cutie.
Hi. Hi, horse.
Look at this cutie.
No, you have to show the horses.
I did.
Can I pet him?
Hi.
I patted the horse.
Finally got around to trying on Kim's new shapewear, guys, and it's really good. Definitely would wear this under a dress. I have so many events that I need something like this for.
Chelsea, what are you wearing?
Skims.
By who?
Kim Kardashian.
Yes. Uh-huh. And this is the
very
new.
Don't worry about it.
Hi, my name's Alexis Gregg, And right now I'm wearing one of my favorite white jumpsuits. With white, it's kind of hard because you can see everything. And one of my little insecure areas is my tummy, especially from weight loss. There's a lot of extra skin there. So I can't wait to try on the Skims shapewear to see how it fits after. Right now I'm wearing the sculpting short in Coco, and it's definitely smoothing me out a lot. I feel very snatched, and in the back it's not making my butt flat at all. I still feel like I have a little hump here. And I'm also wearing pasties, matching pasties. Okay, so I'm back and I feel such a difference. It's so smooth. I don't have any area where it's digging into my skin. Everything feels really tight. I feel snatched. I have the tummy tuck that I always wanted. Everything feels really good in the back as well. I feel great.
Hi, my name is Anna Krylova, and today I'm going to be trying on Skims shapewear. I'm wearing one of my favorite dresses, and I just feel like I want to smooth out some of this part, some of this area, and maybe make my belly look a little more flat. Let's see how it looks. So I'm wearing high-waisted sculpting shirt and sculpting bra. I feel like I'm very supported and snatched. I'm normally a 36G, so I feel like I'm very, very comfortable, and I could wear it all day long. The short make me feel very, very good. So I'm back with my shapewear underneath. I feel very smoothed out and feel very natural, feel very defined. And it's so comfortable, and it actually makes me feel fabulous.
Hey everyone, my name is Sabria, and today I'm going to be trying out some of Skims shapewear. I'm wearing a very bright green dress, and when you wear bright colors, it tends to accentuate everything. So I'm gonna try it on, see if we can tighten some areas up. So right now I'm wearing the high-waist sculpting brief and sculpting bra. It has a nice durable elastic here to prevent any slipping, and it was very easy to get on. I didn't have to jump through any hoops to put on my body. It's very comfortable, I don't feel constricted. So let's put the dress back on and see how it looks. So this is what the dress looks like with the Skims on underneath. I definitely see a big difference. I feel much more supported, and it's very comfortable. It doesn't even feel like I'm wearing shapewear on underneath. So I would highly recommend.
Hey guys, I'm Michaela. I'm wearing a dress that I bought probably about 2 years ago that I've never actually worn because of my insecurities of the tummy area. So I'm excited to try on the Skims shapewear today to hopefully give me more of an hourglass shape and smooth out some of my insecurities. So I'm trying on the sculpting bodysuit. It's really snatching in my waist, flattening in my tummy, and the body color is matching my skin tone perfectly too. As you can see, I'm back. I've got a snatched waist and a nice flat tummy, and I am the newest customer of Skims.
Hello, my name is Allie Weber, and I'm going to be showing you guys the magic of Skims shapewear today. I'm wearing one of my absolute favorite dresses, but I would like things to be just a little bit smoother and tighter underneath it to really rock it. So here's a before for you. I'm wearing the Skims bodysuit, and I could not be more obsessed. I feel tight, I feel smooth. It's one piece, so there's no bumps or lumps where it ends on your stomach, and it's so comfortable. I literally want to wear this as an outfit, throw on a pair of heels, and off we go. I'm back in my favorite dress, but this time I'm wearing the Skims bodysuit underneath, and I could not feel more confident. I feel smooth, I feel tight, I feel snatched. I feel like no one else can even tell I'm wearing shapewear, and frankly, I can hardly tell because it's so comfortable.
I wanted to also mention that the great thing about these is that you don't just have to wear it under things. I know they're meant, you can wear them under dresses or a sweatshirt, whatever you want to kind of sculpt the look for, but you can also just wear them as a plain bodysuit like I have here. You could wear a jacket over it.
Okay, this is my favorite one. The black bodysuit. I'm obsessed. I'm literally obsessed.
Yeah, so I'm basically just going to be wearing sweatpants and this bodysuit for the rest of my life. I'm obsessed. I'm just in love. You guys need to go get these.
Two. 3, 4, 17, 28. Who likes to exercise?
Skip a day.
Oh, I love the shapewear.
I mean, it makes everything look good. You feel supported, smoothed. You just feel more secure and confident.
My name is Kendall. I'm a model. My favorite part of my body is my height.
What do you feel self-conscious about?
Sometimes I'm self-conscious about my broad shoulders. I'm wearing the solution short in clay. I feel like it's hugging my body. It makes me feel more confident. If I could change something in my world, it would be making everyone a little bit nicer.
Make sure, can we shine up one of the legs and maybe the top leg a little bit, and just keep your pose really fantastic with your knees. So beautiful. Gorgeous, heavy. Make sure, can we shine up one of the legs and maybe the top leg a little bit, and just keep your pose really fantastic with your knees. So beautiful. Gorgeous, heavy.
I get to have a nice lunch outside in my backyard. My kids are playing soccer and running around.
So I think I'll start like this with the mirror.
Yep. Ready?
Let's be.
Let's go. Start.
You're Kim Kardashian West.
Okay. Can we go up on the light a little bit?
You're Kim Kardashian West.
Go.
You're Kim Kardashian West.
Go.
You're Kim Kardashian West. Guys, I'm Kim Kardashian West. Get the f*** out of here.
I'm not in it yet.
You need some help?
No, it's okay, best good. To do it by myself.
This is like first incarnation of Skims, but this fabric is, I'm not joking, it is everything. It makes me want to touch myself. I think she goes by Kim, not Kimberly. This is a vintage Bob Mackie that I'm wearing on the show Blackish. See, I pulled it up, which Kim said I could do. I watched her on her Instagram story. She said you can hike them up.
I'm always a little late to the game.
Do you see butterflies?
Yeah.
Are they so pretty?
Yeah. Can I look at them? They're on my face.
Okay. Yeah, they're on your face. Red light. Do you see your eyes? What color are they?
Red light. Red light. There's a butterfly. Again. Red light.
Do you love it?
I want it again.
Red light. That's so cool, right?
Again.
Look at my eyes.
Yeah, go.
One blue, one green. You want to see yours?
Boom. Yay.
Another boom.
We got a hot butterfly. You see a hot butterfly.
Pick your name.
Look at you.
My eyes are not blue.
Oh my gosh, one's blue and one's green. What's that face you're making?
Donating $1 million to Baby to Baby, which is an organization that is helping moms and babies. And, you know, for the longest time, I've worked with them donating, you know, diapers and strollers and tons of baby stuff.
Hi, I'm Gail King. I just spoke to Kim Kardashian West about her new documentary. It's called The Justice Project. And I'll say this. You see a different side of Kim Kardashian West. Hey, Kim.
Hey.
You look the same, but there's something different.
Well, honestly, this is the most important work that I've ever done, so I can't wait for you guys to see it.
All right, thanks, Kim. Coming up on CBS This Morning.
My eco resolution is I eat everything plant-based. Eating a lot of meat wasn't as good for the environment. I try to do everything dairy-free, vegan. I've gotten rid of all straws, most plastic bags, to really work on getting rid of as much plastic in my home as possible.
It's Kate in the Crown Order. I should be nominated for this year's freshman cover because when I was 5 years old, I was the youngest to ever be nominated. Ever since then, I've been working very hard on my music career. I've been co-signed by Kim Kardashian, Kanye West, Casanova, and Wu-Tang Clan. My new single, All the Drip, is coming out. It's gonna be super fire, and I'm gonna take over the game.
To be better short term and to have
no. Oh, I'm going to interrupt you, Haleem, because we have a special guest who has just joined us for this session. Please welcome Kim Kardashian West.
Wait.
Thank you so much, Kim, for joining us. We're having a discussion about the current incarceration crisis and the COVID-19 threat. And we've got a group of Georgetown students here. And unfortunately, we don't have any currently incarcerated. We weren't able to have them join us, but we've got Haleem Flowers, you know, Mamalu Stewart, you know well. We've got Brent Jaffe, who came home on Thursday, just not even a full week ago. We've got Tanya, who you met this summer at the DC jail.
Yay!
And who am I missing? We got Roy Middleton, who came home on December 17th. Thrilled to have you, and this is an exciting time. We've got your documentary that premieres on Sunday evening.
I'm so
students
excited.
All know about it. They're excited.
Have you seen it?
Yeah, I have seen it. I saw the rough cut of it. It was beautiful. Oh, so I'm really excited to have the whole world see it.
Yeah, I know. I did Gail King the other day. Mamalu, she was asking me about you and what you're up to. And I was filling her in. So I can't wait for you guys to see it. I really hope that it just sheds a different light on so many different situations, because it kind of like follows my journey of me feeling, I don't want to say judgmental, but I want to say not really understanding and not really willing to take the time to understand other people's perspectives. And just like seeing something or hearing something on paper and just assuming that, like, just not taking the time to figure out what maybe someone had really been through until I started to go and visit prisons and hear a completely different side. So I hope that people, because I'm obsessed with crime shows and I watch all these like Dateline and Forensic Files and stuff, but nothing is ever from the other side. It's always from the victim's point of view. And I just really think it's important for people to hear that everyone that has been in a situation is a human being, and that like we're no different from just a few different decisions and choices that other people that are incarcerated have made. And I really want to humanize that and get that across.
Yeah, well,
I don't agree with the way she just handled things, but at the same time, I see something in her where she's like, so like her buttons are just pushed.
Mm-hmm.
But she's just like losing her mind over it.
That was crazy.
I think Kim and I both are really surprised as to how things escalated so quickly. We don't really know where all of this has come from. We know that there's been friction recently, but I don't think any of us knew it was this bad and heavy. I don't feel heard from Courtney in a lot of situations. I've just always kind of dealt with it. But when now it's escalating into greater things, yes, now I want you to hear me. Hopefully, this will be a progressive conversation.
I'm supposed to go to Armenia with Kim on Saturday. It's her and I and with all the kids, and we're going to baptize the kids.
Wow.
But I mean, we're not really speaking.
Go.
You guys need it.
So far up Kim's
Oh my God.
Loser.
At least my job is not collecting Kim's money as it falls out of her.
Kim is like...
But without Kim, you'd be nothing. All you'd be doing is chasing Scott at nightclubs every night. I don't know who told you that you're the queen of this castle, that you don't need to work, because you do. She's been working, I know, since I'm up her all day, has been working 365 days for the last 4 years while you've been pregnant and doing nothing.
Why the am I even listening to you?
I don't know.
Why are you talking?
I don't know. You're delusional, you're a psycho, and you're... Bitch.
Why don't you leave? Don't you have your own place?
Scott's never gonna marry you.
How cute is my mom? Just send me this little Easter house for the kids. They are gonna love it. This little village. So cute, Mom. I love you. Here is our seamless collection. It is super stretchy. And look at this. There's like no seam. It's so amazing. It comes in 5 colors. Really good shade range. And it comes in a thong. Our full bottom brief. Our boy short that's high-waisted. This tank is exactly like our cotton rib tank from the cotton collection, but it is in this like amazing, super stretchy, it's really thin, kind of this like seamless material. It's really, really, really amazing.
Join us and watch as my team works to free people from the darkness of imprisonment.
This is the Justice Project. Let's unlock hope.
I think I've always been pretty mindful of what's going on, but never to this extent. I really had no idea what our justice system was like. And it just was started off from me being on social media, on Twitter, seeing a video of Alice Johnson. And all she had to do was say that she has a low level first time drug offense, has the same sentence as Charles Manson. And that clicked to me. Mm-hmm. And I thought, well, I didn't know what to do or what had happened. And so I really wanted to figure it out. Like, well, what was it? Did she not have a good attorney?
did she, like, I really didn't know what would get someone in that cell. I sent it to my attorney. And as you go, like, there's, you realize there's so much more that can be done. There's so much more that has to be done. And I couldn't just sit back and, if I knew that I could help make a difference, I couldn't just sit back and not.
Okay, this episode totally got me emotional because Kim and Courtney visit Armenia and just bring awareness to the Armenian genocide, which she has always done. But I thought it was such a great episode and I highly recommend you guys checking it out.
Are keeping up with the Kardashians fan base have watched my journey. They want to see a different glimpse and more in-depth look into the work that I've been doing. This Justice Project hugs at my heart. I wanted to fight for justice reform and showcase specific people in specific cases to explain how unfair our system is. Join me as we shine a light on injustice.